Get ready to match the stars.
You bet.
Nipsey Russell. Loretta Swit. Charles Nelson Reilly. Brett Summer. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73.
Yay!
And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rivers.
Yeah, he is.
Hello there.
Video.
How are you? Hello there. Are you Johnny Olson? How do you do? Is everyone all right?
We're all right.
We're perfect.
That's what I keep saying, everybody. Everyone's all right over here.
Well, you've got a butterfly on you there. You better get it.
I have
it
a butterfly on my luck. Adam's apple. I did that all by myself.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to prove it, because it'll take me forever to do it. What do you say we give a brisk round of applause to our two players here, Donnelly Parrish and John Sterling? He's the current champ. He's won one game, has $1,200. They tied the game that Donna Lee challenged him on, and we went to the tiebreaker. We put the question to Donna Lee, and she didn't score any matches with her end of the tiebreaker. And we're about to get to his end of the tiebreaker, and all he needs is one to win the game. And we'll find out if that happens right after we find out about this. The second half of the tiebreaker. Here we go. John, you don't have to make a selection because A is it, B was her question, everyone plays, this is it. Let's see if we break this tie. John not only had flat feet, he had a flat blank. Think about that. Or his men. Nothing personal, John. John not only had flat feet, he had a flat blank. Betty ready? Brett's ready. Waiting for old Nipsey up there.
Yes.
Just slip it in there. Attaboy.
I keep forgetting.
All right. John not only had flat feet, he had a flat blank. John, what answer do you think would match your celebrities here?
Tire.
Flat tire. Oh, why you boy? You don't think that's a good answer?
You'll learn how to play the game after that.
All right, we'll find out now. We're going to find out whether he's got a good answer. The audience thinks he's got a bad answer. His answer is tire. Nipsey, what do you say? One match is all he needs to win the game.
My Uncle George died with flat feet.
He did?
Yeah, a guy caught his feet in the wrong flat.
Flat head.
See?
Loretta, he's looking for the answer.
Absolutely. No, flat head.
Flat head. Head so far, John.
Another flat head.
Three flat heads up there.
Would you like to make it full?
One flat tire will win the game. What have you got?
I'm not going to tell you. You just have to guess. Head.
Head it is. Go ahead. And you, sir, what have you got?
Well, so far we have what we call the Klugman's five flat heads.
Five flat heads. One flat tire wins it for him. What can you do for us, Betty?
Now, one flat tire may cause a lot of trouble. It's a head.
Oh, flat head. Six flat heads, and that means we go to another tiebreaker. There it is. Donna Lee, you got another chance.
Mind if I go take a rest?
Take a rest? It's exciting.
Why don't you go take a blank?
You gotta make a selection.
Why don't you go back to Greece?
B. All right. B is her choice.
B.
Everyone plays. This is your assignment, folks. Jane said to Bill.
Oh, they're sweet.
If you've just come from the office, why do you reek of blank? Jane said to Bill, if you've just come from the office, why do you reek of blank?
This is a multiple choice question, Jane.
Just put one answer down. One simple answer is
right.
All right. Slipping the slop there and you're all set.
You got it, baby.
She's all ready. All right. Donna Lee, Jane said to Bill, if you've just come from the office, why do you reek of
Liquor.
You're yaying again, huh?
Hello, yeah.
This is the yayingest, nayingest audience we've ever had. All right, she says liquor. What do you say, Nipsey?
Jane, one of those women that can't hit the garage door but can see a hair on your coat. Perfume. Yay.
You're yay in liquor and you're yay in perfume. You like all the answers, huh?
They're
okay,
friendly.
Loretta.
Jane didn't mind his drinking. It was his other women.
The perfume.
Okay.
It certainly smells up here.
It does. You get the drift of it, the wafting all the way up there. Liquor is what we're looking for.
Well, I don't mind Jack's women, but I hate his liquor, but I said perfume anyway.
All right, four times so far, Donnelly. What do you say, Richard?
Last time I saw Jack, he was drinking perfume. Liquor.
Four once there. All right, Betty, liquor.
No, a little Chanel on the rocks. Never hurt anybody. I mean.
So you got one match there. Now let's see how John does with his end of the tiebreaker. You need one to tie, two to win. Amanda loved to ride her bicycle, but it made her blank ache. Yeah. Amanda loved to ride her bicycle, but it made her blank ache. You're laughing at your answer.
No, I wasn't at all.
Oh, all right. All right, I got Sarah already down there and up here, and here we go. All right, let's get an answer from John Stern. A man who loved to ride her bicycle, but it made her...
Backside or rear?
Backside or rear. Okay.
Did he say beer or rear?
Rear.
Rear.
Oh,
all right.
Backside, rear, bottom. Any of those answers, I suppose, would be acceptable. One match is all he
going,
needs to
Gene,
tie. Two to win. Nipsey, what do you say?
Well, all you do is sit on the back part. You pedal with the legs.
It's the legs, there. I see. The legs do the work. Okay, Loretta?
I thought of backache, but I said spine.
Spine?
Yes.
Well, to make up for the others on my corner up here, I put seat, rear, or behind.
Seat, rear, or you got them all there. Coming in from all angles. Now we have a tie. One more match. John wins. One more bottom wins a game for him. All right, Brett. Go.
Yes. Back. Could you tap a little side on the side?
No.
You
got
sure?
The back. You're in the spinal column area there. Let's see what area Richard is in.
I thought he said something.
As I said, the legs ache.
The legs ache.
Sure,
keeping them up
biker.
On the
handlebars.
You
may set a new record here. If we don't get another backside, we got another tie, Betty.
Well, I've hit bottom on this one. Fanny.
Yeah.
Hey!
Congratulations. Come on down, John. Okay. Take your usual spot there. You got another $100. Donnelly, it's been a pleasure meeting a pretty girl like you. You were fun. Yeah. All right, we've got a gift for you. Let's say goodbye to Donnelly Parrish. Thank you, dear. All right, we'll get back and talk to John right after this. John Stern here is ready to have another go at the Big Money Super Match. Aren't you ready, John?
Very.
Okay, here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Charlie Blank. The answer they gave most often, as you know, is worth $500. If you can match it. Second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100. Now you may solicit three celebrity answers and see how much help you can get from them, John.
Betty, please.
Charlie?
Chaplin.
She says Chaplin.
Richard, please.
And Richard Dawson?
A Charlie Horse.
Charlie Horse. I knew him well.
And Nipsey, please.
Are you reading the Peanuts thing, Charlie Brown?
Well, yes.
Charlie Brown.
Yes.
Okay, you got Charlie Brown, Charlie Horse, and Charlie Chaplin. What do you want to do? Do you want to choose one of those or give us one of your own?
I think I'll go with Nipsey's answer of Charlie Brown.
You think that's the best one?
Five.
Okay. That is the one we are looking for, Charlie Brown. Let's begin by revealing the $100 response. Charlie Chaplin is up there, the one that Betty White gave you. All right, still looking for Charlie Brown. Here is the $250 response. Charlie Chan. Very interesting answer and a good one. Ah, so, yes. Last chance, John. Looking for Charlie Brown. Here is the $500 response. Okay. Well, we congratulate you. You've got a chance at the real big money now because the $500 means you'll be playing for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Now, to collect the money,
You've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis, and we ask you to make that choice now.
I think I'll go with my luck with Nipsey.
Yeah?
Nipsey, are you ready? You get ready to write now, Nipsey. You have to write the answer here, and you face me, John. Here is the $5,000 question. Blank book. B-O-O-K.
Blank book?
Blank book or blank book. I'll give you both accents.
Okay.
Put it in the slot there, and the little dinger dings, that means that you're ready. Now, how about you, sir? Have you come up with an answer for this fill-in blank book?
Since I hope to be able to use the money later on, I'll go with the checkbook.
Oh. Checkbook is what he says. All right, Nipsey, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
For $5,000, I'll make a call. Phone book.
Phone book is what he says. Both good answers, checkbook, phone book. All right, you've picked up another $500, brings you up to $1,800. John, you're still the champ. You're going to meet another player now. Here comes Kathy Carillas. The two of you know each other, and you wish each other well. I wish you, we wish you well, too. Kathy, would you tell us a little about yourself?
Well, I have a beautiful little girl. She's 3 years old. I'm a dental assistant, and I work in an oral surgery office in Pasadena.
You work in a what?
Oral surgery.
Oral surgery office. Oh, okay. All right, good luck to you here, Kathy. You know that you and John will be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities. And you'll have two rounds to play. The one who's matched most celebrities at the end of the second round will be the winner and have a go at the big money in the super batch. Now, our challenger makes a selection, so would you do that, please?
B.
B is what Kathy wants. Everyone participates. Are you ready, wise ones? Rumor has it that the three musketeers all share the same blank. Everybody in the block is talking about it. Rumor has it that the three musketeers all share the same blank.
Well.
No help, please. We appreciate your enthusiasm.
I'm ready.
I know you are.
I'm ready.
Okay.
Betty White's not ready.
Yeah, everybody's ready. The lights are all on over there.
Oh, okay. Pardon me.
Now we'll call on Kathy Carillas and ask her for her response to this. Rumor has it that the three musketeers all share the same...
bed.
Bed. She says bed? Bed is her answer, folks. Nipsey, what do you say about the three musketeers?
All for one and one for all.
Old swordsman, I never did suspect it of him. What do you say,
well,
Loretta?
Well, it's quite true, you know.
There's another one.
Yes, but to take it a further step further, once they were there, look who came along.
Yes,
I wouldn't say the word.
Broad is
board.
His
it's a
answer.
Broad sword,
yes.
You're speaking of.
Now let's come down here to Brett Summers.
Well, no matter what anybody said about them, it wasn't true. They were perfectly normal young men, but they did share the same bed.
All right, you're up for three matches there. Now let's check Richard Dawson.
This ought to be good.
I was always taught if you couldn't say something nice about someone,
yes,
say nothing at all.
Right.
So I'm going to say no. They all shared the same hairdresser. Jack of Maple Drive.
Who? What was the hairdresser's name?
Jacques of Maple Drive.
Jacques of Maple
Tall
Drive.
Tall fellow with a broom.
Yes.
We must okay.
That's enough. All right.
Walk strangely.
Let's see what you've got. She's looking for the answer, Ben.
I know she's looking for that, but I have to straighten these fellas out because, you know, for the good of the youth of America, they shared the same girl.
Oh-ho. Well,
that'll help the youth.
Who?
What kind of an answer is that to help the youth of America, Miss White, or if you prefer Mrs. Ludden?
That's okay. It's a good
same
answer.
Girl?
And we'll get to John's end of this round right after we get to this. No, please don't go away.
No.
All right. Here we go now. We complete round one. Kathy did pretty well with hers. Scored three matches. John, this is for you. Let's see how you do with this. Everyone plays. Are you ready? Janet. laughed so hard at the comedy, she blinked.
There's gotta be an easier way.
There is.
Did I hear that
Nipsey
one?
Nipsey says that Janet laughed so hard at the comedy, she blinked. That's it. Okay.
What
got
you
the idea.
See's what you
That's
get.
A lovely fabric.
It's my wrapper.
Oh.
She.
Don't think too hard. It's maybe a terrible strain on you.
I am not able to think too hard.
Okay, so she's ready, and now we'll call on John Stern for his response. Janet laughed so hard at the comedy, she...
cried.
She cried. That's a logical answer. She laughed so hard, she cried.
Yes,
Nipsey, what do you say? Are you logical?
She emitted a saline solution. She cried.
She cried. And next, sir. Loretta.
And then she popped a button.
She popped a button. Really?
And then she cried again because she hadn't paid for the dress.
Oh-ho. All right, you scored twice up there. Let's see if you score down here.
Well, actually, she laughed so hard she went like that and then belched.
Oh, she did. Okay.
Right?
Richard Dawson.
Please, I don't want to get involved.
Cry
so hard, she ached.
Ached. She ached. Okay, what do you say?
But she also cried into her
bathroom.
Yeah. All in another time.
So we've got a tie there at the end of round one. Score
Nobody
is tied 3-3. Let's see if we can break the tie now. Kathy, make a selection.
B again.
B is what she wants. Last time out, you matched Brett, Nipsey, and Loretta. So
Leia.
You're trying to match the others. The three I've just mentioned, you do not write now.
Right.
Most people don't know this, but Buffalo Bill got his name because he blanked like a buffalo.
I miss all the good ones.
That's right, you do. I think I'll write an answer to this myself. Most people don't know this, but Buffalo Bill got his name because he blanked like a buffalo. You ready over there? Come on, Charles, you gotta write something.
I changed it.
You changed. All right, everybody's ready. So, Kathy, we call on you. Buffalo Bill got his name because he blanked like a buffalo. What do you say?
He smelled.
Smelled like a buffalo. She says he smelled like a buffalo. So, Charles, you're first.
And you're dying to know what I said.
I'm dying to know what you said.
Well, I first wrote he looked like a buffalo, but after he was in the room a while, everyone agreed that he certainly did smell like
a buffalo. Smell like a buffalo, so there you score once. Now we go to Richard.
Well, I just think that's a terrible thing to say about buffaloes. Now, he did look like, but he never
like
smelled
a
like a buffalo ever.
They do smell bad, you know.
Well,
have
I'm
you
not going to start
one?
That rumor.
Yes,
they've never done me any harm.
What do you say?
But not to another buffalo.
Right.
That's the difference. He smelled like a buffalo.
Smelled like a buffalo. So Kathy's up to 5, and now we go to John. You've got to match 2 celebrities to achieve a tie. 3 will win the game. You ready? Here we go. Last time out, you matched Nipsey, Charles, and Betty, and now you'll be trying to capture the others. Mary said...
We don't write now.
No, you don't write. Mary said, you write.
What do I write?
Home for money.
If you can write your name, we'll let you drive home.
Okay, this is a very important
moment
for John Stern. Now. Okay. Nipsey, Charles, and Betty do not participate. The others do. Mary said, I wish John wouldn't hum Stars and Stripes Forever while we're blanking. Yes. Loretta's ready.
Oh, I'm ready.
As usual, we're waiting for Brett to catch up with the rest of the gang here.
When you get to be my age, you better be ready. Because not many people are going to wait for it.
Okay. John, it's time for your response. Mary said, I wish John wouldn't hum Stars and Stripes Forever while we're blanking.
Kissing?
Kissing. That's his answer. Now you need 2 to tie, 3 to win. And Loretta, we call on you first.
I don't know whether John's patriotic or romantic, but I said kissing.
Kissing. There's one. You need 1 more for the tie. And let's come down here to Brett.
Well, actually, I said kissing in a way.
Wait a
but
minute.
They were married.
Yeah.
You see, so they were able to kiss and they were able, whether
making,
making
love is her answer.
Is that,
we'll
isn't that the
toward
same
the judges.
Thing
no, they say, no, that is not a match.
And
now, you must match Richard Dawson to achieve a tie and stay in the game. No, listen, we don't like sore losers here, so stop tearing that up there.
Listen, man, let me give her a lump of sugar. She loves
all right, that. It's 5-4, one match, looking for kissing.
Well, kissing is a lovely thought, and I just went a little further. I put loving.
Loving. That does not match, so Kathy Carinius is the winner. Congratulations. Okay, Kathy, would you stand right here, please? Congratulations to you. You've got $100. We've got to say goodbye to John Stern, but he's going to leave here with $1,800. It's been a pleasure having you here on Match 1073. So long, John. Good luck to you. We'll get back to Kathy to talk with her right after this. Kathy Carilius will join us next time for the Super Match, where she's going to try to win $5,000.
Wow.
And all of these beautiful, talented people will join us next time, too.
You know, Betty was right at the beginning of the show. You do have a beautiful farfalla. Farfalla means bow tie in Italian.
Oh, I see. Thank you very much.
Nervous.
You're a very splendid fellow.
With blades like you, he doesn't even
Say goodnight, Nick.
Say goodnight, Nick. We'll see you next time, whenever that is. So long. Gene Rayburn for Match Game 73.
Today's consolation prizes are a wearing air freshenizer. It fills the room with a fresh, clean scent and helps make the air you breathe a little nicer without mist or vapor from wearing. And Dark Eyes, the once-a-month eyelash and eyebrow makeup that creates a beautiful, glamorous eyes that won't run, smear, wash off, cream off, or even pry off. This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.